Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity, The White March, Part 1. I'm the RPG Chick.
Hard living in a place like this. It's a wonder anybody stayed at all.
Okay. Alright, so we just saved somebody from this burning wreck, and before that we chased off... What were they? Clan... Something ogres. Some kind of ogres. These guys are still putting out the fire here. We're damn lucky you arrived when you did. That's right. We'll admit it. So many good people dead. What we got here? Brintwin ban is that one of the things we found already or no? I guess we found that already. Yeah, we've seen that. Okay. Loving the theme again. Awesome. Hey, camping supplies. Unfortunately, we're full. Got to remember this place, though. Okay, so this is... Who? Taena's house. As usual, we'll just go in random people's houses. And poke around in their stuff. Look, I can't take this stuff. This is stealing, right? Stag hide. Something about deer. A bronze Abaddon statuette. Many households in Durgan's Battery had a statuette of Abaddon that was cast in the White Forge. The original was made by a renowned Aptapo sculptor. This music is very triumphant.
They gone? Have those nasty brutes finally left?
Yep. What you got over here? Fine dagger and stalwart bony? What is that? Stalwart's residents use assorted pieces of carved fishbone as a supplemental currency. Most bonies are carved from a large flat spot on the skulls of speckleback fish. The carvings are intricate enough that the outsiders find them valuable for their artistry.
I heard the ogres outside, tearing down walls and murdering folk. Don't remember how things got this bad.
The elderly woman needs her hands. Her knuckles are swollen knobs, and her palms are ridged with calluses that scrape and rasp as she rubs them together.
But you're the new adventurer, Renengild's latest volunteer.
She squints at you, leaning precariously forward on her wobbling legs. Apparently the rest of us are invisible.
A real spitfire, she told me. Bet you'd whip those layabouts at the mine into shape.
I'd like to ask you something.
Did you say something, dear?
Yes, tell me about yourself.
Me? I was the overseer at the mine, back when it was running. Got shut down decades ago when we couldn't sell or ship the stuff. But I still remember plenty about the mining business. And I got as many folk as I can digging out the entrance.
She taps her head, a spotted dome under a thinning thatch of hair.
Been praying to the salty wench that I don't forget too much afore they finish the job.
She winks. That is all.
Got to speak up? My hearing ain't what it was.
I said, you're really tall. Some more Brintwin ban. And this Rinnan Guild is in there, probably. This guy looks very cold. We'll have to talk with Rinnan Guild. I'm just a messenger. Yeah, I could do that yet. And this goes out to Durgan's battery. Gref's Rest. Reyfald.
Don't see the harm. Building's thirsty work.
Huh?
Figured you'd be out of here in a flash after the fighting died down. Most people don't stick around after they figure out the ogres are making regular visits.
Well, you know, we haven't gotten our drink yet. Then we'll be on our way.
I would have helped fight them monsters off, you know, if I didn't think I'd just get in the way.
Yeah, sure.
I'm with you there to handle things. Everything turned out well enough, didn't it? Don't see why Havrick's still sour at me.
Hmm. Maybe because you're a coward. What's this about Havrick?
Oh, Havrick's the innkeeper over at the Grave's Rest. I may have been hiding in the inn when the fighting started. The raid didn't improve his disposition any.
The Grave's Rest, okay.
Did you know he has a whole case of Fenlin liquor in there?
Oh, yeah?
I keep offering to buy it off him. But he says he's saving it up for when the battery's open again.
Looks like you're only up into your own interests.
As if we're gonna last that long. Anyhow, he said he'd thrash me up and down the mountain if I didn't leave him be.
Probably will. So you hid away while everyone else risked their lives.
That's what Havrick said, actually.
Uh-huh.
Look, I'm not proud of it, but I'm no warrior. What am I gonna do? Throw a net on them?
Hmm. And now you're worried about some fancy drink?
They say a single drop changes your life. You'll never want to have a drink of anything else. Probably that's all rubbish, but it's supposed to be very good.
I see.
It's delusional is what it is. Hey, look, maybe... Not that you have the face for it or anything, but maybe you could help me out.
What the hell are you telling me? I don't have the face for what? Oh, bravo, Elas says. Subtle indeed.
Havrick keeps all the good stock in the inn cellar. Out of sight, you see. I mean, it's bound to be under lock and key, but I'm sure he wouldn't miss a single bottle. Not with everything that's going on.
What would I get out of this?
I'll pay you for it. I swear it. We'll split my wages. And the bottle, too, if you like. I just want to be able to say these lips have tasted the best the Ishimidal Plains have to offer.
Hmm. Anyone ever tell you you're a little strange, Reyfald?
Nothing so kind. You try living here a few years and see how you turn out.
Reyfald is desperate for a taste of Fenlin liquor, and the only source of it is Havrick's private and zealously guarded stocks. So he's the clerk at the local fishery. He claims that Havrick has a store of expensive spirits at the inn, tucked away somewhere in the cellar. Reyfald has offered me a reward in exchange for finding a bottle for him.
Please, tell me you found it. I've got a craving like you wouldn't believe.
We haven't moved yet. Now we've moved. It's down around the other side. Is there somebody in there? Apparently there's somebody in the outhouse. I'm not done yet, damn it. That's funny. Want all your vegetation. More ringer berries. Oh! Something over there.
Now what the flame has shown us?
A rat nest. With two civilushis. However you say that. Can I get to this from over the... Yeah. Meat? I'll leave that. What is this? Thyrsc's house? Awfully sudden. Let's start it again. Fish. Tundra clothing, huh? The frigid environment of regions like the White March makes these fur outfits a requirement for survival. The outfit is a combination of waterproofed leather and fur designed to retain heat while repelling moisture. Got a scroll of defense. Potion of major endurance. So, plus 20 all defenses for 15 seconds. This tightly wound scroll describes the means by which to cast a broad enchantment of protection upon one's allies, though it requires all to stand within the circle of its influence in order to benefit from it. The spell greatly increases one's ability to ward off attacks by raising their reflexes as well as providing magical resistance against harm. We got another camping supply, too.
A simple test.
Oh, no.
It must be soon. 2 days, no more.
That sounds like a dare. The shaft of each spear is splintered and broken, each of them held together only by tightly bound leather straps. These necklaces have been made from the teeth and claws of various predators, wolves, bears, and lions. This dwarf is busy staring into the fire, slowly puffing away on his pipe. As you greet him, he's visibly startled, and his pipe clatters to the floor.
Sorry. Didn't hear you come in. My ears aren't what they used to be.
He stoops, wincing, to retrieve his pipe. When he rises again, he has a hand against his side. Are you hurt?
Wasn't the ogres, I can tell you that. Put a few arrows in one of those, and they generally have the good sense to back off. But... I've been hunting this wolf for near a year now. A man-eater. Cunning, nasty thing. Every time I get close, it just slips away. The beast has already claimed many lives. The first victim was my son, Saldrin.
Thyrsc looks down at his pipe for a moment, features hardening.
Got the better of me this last time. Distracted me long enough for one of its kin to turn up. Nearly bit me clean in half.
He winces.
I'm a few weeks out from trying again.
You said this thing is a wolf?
No ordinary wolf. A monster. This creature is big. And I see the signs it leaves behind. The mess it made to the last couple of hunters and the elk. Doesn't always finish its meals. Damn thing might be sick. Might have a bullet in its jaw. Something. In any case, it needs to be put down.
Where is this beast?
It roams the russet wood out to the west. Seems to have decided the lake is a good place to find prey. Yeah. It's picked off some scattered ogres from time to time. But mostly it's been going after hunters. Travelers.
Can you tell me about your previous encounters?
Nothing to tell. Near misses, all of them. One time he clambered right up the cliffs to avoid my snares. Another time, he chased a bear into my camp.
Huh.
I nearly had him once. I could hear him below, eating, and I had the gun aimed right for him. Until the wind changed. He charged headlong into the tree to get at me. Nearly knocked me off my perch. And when I righted myself, he was gone.
What's that last option? I see? I don't know.
It needs doing. But I warn you, this beast is not to be trifled with. It must make its lair somewhere to the west. If you mean to go there, keep your wits about you. Watch yourself on the mountain. In these lean times, everything looks like prey to something.
Right, so who are you anyway?
I'm Thyrsc.
Thyrsc.
I've lived here long enough that Kith have started calling me the Old Hunter. And that's about all I can say for myself.
I have some questions.
Coming to your elders for advice, is it? What can I do for you?
What can you tell me about Stalwart?
Well, I can tell you it won't be here much longer if things go on as they are. With the mines closed, we've lost what put us on the map in the first place. We're losing people every month. Too many mouths to feed and not enough to support them. Even the game's dwindling. I've been lucky. I've hides and horns enough to keep the traders happy, but now the ogres are picking the rest of us off.
Right. What can you tell me about these ogres? Only that they've been coming down in force again and again, trying to drive us out or kill us outright.
The moment we started looking into Durgan's battery, it was like we'd kicked a hornet's nest.
Yeah, I keep wondering if like they didn't record that line, or they did, and for some reason it doesn't play. I don't know.
You made a good showing against that last group, by the way. I think you've given them reason to think twice about coming back.
Has the legacy struck Starward as well?
It has. We had some hope in the early days that we'd be spared, isolated as we are. That hope died in a hurry. Not everyone's been so unlucky, of course. You'll see a few pampered sprats around.
Not everyone's been so lucky. Treating them like precious stones won't see them grow up any faster, if at all. The sudden sorrow in his features belies his soft laughter. Why is the hunting so poor?
It's been a colder season than usual, and the elk herds aren't faring well. We're stuck fighting with the ogre clans and the wolves over what's left. Not to mention the occasional beast. We've lost a lot of young hunters.
You must have some interesting hunting stories.
Long hours checking snares and waiting out elk, mostly. Used to hunt some of the big ones. Bear, Stelgar. But up here, it comes down to necessity. Which means keeping Stalwart fed, or else keeping it safe. Thing is, the last hunt didn't go so well, as you can see.
Well, that's all the questions I had. Thyrsc only inclines his head in his acknowledgement. In acknowledgement, tapping out his pipe. Farewell. One of Stalwart's best hunters, Thyrsc, has found his match in a cunning wolf that has repeatedly eluded his efforts to trap and kill it. While his most recent injuries prevent him from making another attempt himself, Thyrsc hopes that the beast can be dealt with before it preys upon more villagers. Thyrsc has described his hunt for a dangerous and very large wolf that is preying on villagers within the Russet Wood. According to Thyrsc, the wolf makes its lair in the area, although he has not been able to determine the den's location.
Watch yourself on the mountain. In these lean times, everything looks like prey to something.
Okay. Ydran. The Orlin bows to you. Ah, the adventurer who saved the village. So good of you to visit my humble wagon. I am Ydran. How's business? He gestures at the village around him. Poor, like this place. Not much coin to be made trading in furs and such. I came to the White March because I assumed there would be no competition, and I have none, because there's nothing to compete over out here. Would you like to trade? If you're not making any money out here, why do you stay? His eyes lower. I was rather vocal about my inevitable success with my friends and family. If I give up and return with little more than I left, then... His hands ball into fists. No, it won't be like that. I'm not giving up yet. Shit, what do you have for sale? Raiment of Whale's Eyes. It's light armor. Grants mirrored image when hit by a critical hit. That's pretty interesting. Plus 10 defense against charm-dominated and confused attacks. This gray cloak is covered in a multitude of stylized eyes, symbols of the god Whale. It is said to have been created by the wizard Gorin, who hoped that the pious endeavor might invoke Whale's protection. Set against the many eyes of the Hundred Mysteries, Gorin hoped his enemies would stumble after falsehoods, while he would remain hesitant to the bewildering effects of the world's mysteries. Those who have come across the cloak since have found much use in its enchantments. What became of Gorin himself is unknown, however, for nothing else remains of the man or his works. Light armor. Well, I say buy it. Let's see if I can enchant it with stuff. Ultimate Hat of Alluring Perfection. Really? Plus 2 might and constitution. Minus 2 intellect and resolve? Oh, I don't like that. This hat was designed by an apprentice wizard who sought to create the perfect magical accessory. He spent weeks binding spells and wards to the material, but when he finished, he felt that it looked rather plain. He wanted to strike an imposing figure for peers and rivals, so he began a few more days adding embellishments. A crest of feathers behind one ear, a band of silk around the brim. It was an improvement, but it also showed the young wizard how poorly he'd chosen his original color scheme, so he spent a few more days experimenting with other shades in suede, satin, and leather. While the young apprentice obsessed over his hat, his peers continued studying spells and hexes. By the time of his first duel, he had assembled a fantastic wardrobe but forgotten many of his spells. His performance ended his budding career in magic most ignominiously, but he went on to become a successful tailor. Yeah, I don't want that if it's giving us negatives and stuff. Rufex Watchful Cloak MK2? Plus 2 enemies needed to flank? No, plus 2 perception. Rufek was a bruiser and a follower of Whale. He was often hired as a courier or bodyguard because of his size and strength. Yet he was a quiet man, and he developed a habit of walking with his head bowed in prayer. Because of this, would-be thieves frequently attempted to waylay him. But Rufek was blessed by the God of Secrets. With uncanny foresight, he dodged and parried these sudden attacks and slew his assailants, sewing their eyes into his cloak. He intended it as a warning, but others saw it as a challenge. Eventually, he discarded this cloak and wore a simpler, subtler garment in its place. The sight of a dark cloak with shimmering, shifting eyes became infamous among highwaymen and bandits. Ryona's buckle. This could take a while, guys. Oh, excuse me. Plus 5 accuracy when below 50% endurance. Plus 10 defense against disease and poison. This belt bears the mark of Ryona, a legendary adventurer who traveled Eora in search of wealth and fame. When she was young, she trained at a martial academy in Ozia, where she struggled at first. Many of her fellow students came from wealthy local families, but she was poor and foreign. But she was clever, and she practiced much. One day, her chief rival, the nephew of one of the Duke's bells, challenged her to a duel. Ryona could not refuse and save face, so she accepted. When they had assembled in the arena, he offered to give her one piece of his armor before the fight began. He meant it as an insult to her skill, but when Ryona asked for his belt, he realized his mistake. He gave her his belt with his sheathed rapier still attached to it, effectively disarming himself. Ryona won the duel by default and kept the belt as a memento. Oh, he's not too bright, is he? Interesting, though. Gauntlets of accuracy. Plus 5 accuracy. Scroll of Hailstorm. Calls down a savage storm of sleet and ice chunks, causing crush and freeze damage to any in the area of effect. Okay, 30 to 42 crush and 25% damage as freeze versus reflex. Restore critical stamina. Scroll. Plus 55 endurance. Chaotic orb trap. Name for the eccentric Ydran wizard Taena. The chaotic orb bounces between a number of enemies, dealing damage and inflicting a variety of negative afflictions, including petrified, paralyzed, weakened, sickened, stunned, and blinded. I'm not gonna read all that. It's pretty interesting, though. Potion of Barring Death's Door. Flame Shield. Lockpick, sure, why not? Okay, so where is this thing? Oh no, I did want to hold on to that, actually. Ah, here it is. Cool, we made it exceptional. Yeah, we'll use that. Right? Let me just check again. Yeah, better damage reduction. Actually, no, not as good. Down by 1. Oh, what the hell? It's interesting looking, huh? Okay. Okay, we haven't seen these falls yet. Or whatever. Nah, springs, actually, I meant. Barret spell. Familiar flower. How do I get into these springs? Or can I? Can't look at them or do anything? Give me a few minutes, will you? Let's see if anyone's at the fishery now.
Fresh fish! Freshly caught!
Loud.
Apogee's eyes! It looked at me!
What?